It's a good delivery, full of legs. That's gone for six runs. And welcome the Indian Premier League Season 10 Extravaganza continues. 12 matches already being played, a 13th one being played as we speak. And tonight we are going to discuss about match 14 as well between Delhi and Punjab. We will also be reviewing the match that is going on right now between Kolkata Knight Riders and Sunrisers Hyderabad. A match that will decide who will be the current table topper of the IPL. NewsX brings you Cricket Carnival as we discuss, analyze and bring everything from the world of IPL. Virat Kohli's coach Rajkumar Sharma joins us in the studio as always. Also joining me will be sports guru Himanshu Chaturvedi live from Delhi, and as well former India cricketer and selected Sabah Karim, who will also be joining us from Mumbai. A power-packed panel, and let's dive straight in to the big preview for today, the match which starts in a few minutes from now. Resurgent Delhi will take on Punjab in match number 14 of the IPL at the Feroz Shah Kotla Stadium in New Delhi. Zaheer Khan and co will hope to continue momentum at home. Chris Morris and Sanju Samson, who have been in supreme form for the Delhi Daredevils alongside Rishabh Pant, and the trio will hope to continue in a similar manner. Now, Delhi comes in this game after a majestic win against Pune and will want to show their mettle against Punjab as well. Zaheer has been in good form and has led the side well. Meanwhile, Punjab will hope to find their mojo back and shrug off the disappointment after the loss against KKR in the previous encounter. Glenn Maxwell will want to fire with a bat and expect his bowlers to shine in containing the Delhi batsmen.
Yeah, this was the last time I bowled the last match. I'm very happy the way I bowled. Koshish ye rahegi ki isme bhi usse aur zyada attacking dale ball, unse zyada attacking hamara field placement, unse zyada acha attacking hamara thinking hona chahiye, kyunki achhi team hai no doubt, aur hamare paas जो बॉलिंग अटैक है हमारा उनसे बेटर है, तो कोशिश यही रहेगा कि जो भी हम प्लानिंग करें उनसे बेटर हो.
इनिशियली व्हेन वी वर बैटिंग द बॉल वाज टेकिंग इनटू द विकेट इफ यू आर हिटिंग द लेंथ, बट नाउ एज द ड्यू कम्स यू नो द बॉल वाज कमिंग नाइसली ऑन टू द बैट. आई थिंक ऑब्वियसली इन सिक्स ओवर्स इफ यू गिव 80 रन्स आई डोंट थिंक सो यू कैन विन इवन इफ यू स्कोर 200.
Let's go to our esteemed panel and get their views first. Sabha, coming to you first. Will Delhi live up to the billing and get off to a positive start at the Kotla? What is your opinion?
I expect DD to do well because they seem to have found the right kind of combination. Zaheer Khan, as a captain, has inspired his young cricketers to do well. Some of the youngsters have started to come good. Sanju Samson, we saw them in the last game, he played such a splendid knock. Rishabh Pant has shown great promise. So yes, and I expect Shreyas Iyer to get fit. So he can be in the final 11 in place of, I think, Karun Nair. So they have got all their combinations sorted out. So I think that the Delhi Daredevils should get off to a good start in the first home game.
Rajkumar, both Delhi Daredevils and Kings XI Punjab have been two teams who have been there from season one, but somehow, despite doing well in the first season, they have never really been consistent table toppers. Yeah, they have always been at the bottom of the table more often than not. This time, though, the progress for both the teams have been slightly more promising than last time.
Yeah, especially for Punjab, if you see, they are playing very well and they look a very good unit this time. Earlier also they had very good players, match winners, but somehow they were not clicking as a team. But now it looks this time they have done their preparations well and they are going very nicely in this particular IPL. And so is Delhi.
Yes.
We have always found it a very weak side, you know, every time with due to some injuries or some lack of planning, they have never had a very good team. But the way they have played the last game with Sanju Samson, Rishabh Pant and Morris, I mean, they look a very balanced team and a very competitive team now.
Indeed. Sava, will Delhi's bowlers be able to contain Punjab's batsmen? Because that seems to be the face encounter if you sum it up.
I feel that Zaheer Khan and Rahul Dravid together must have worked out some kind of a plan. Delhi has a very strong bowling attack. They have Zaheer Khan, they have Chris Morris, then they have Zaheer Khan and Rahul Dravid together must have worked out some kind of a plan. Delhi has a very strong bowling attack. They have Zaheer Khan, they have Chris Morris, then they have Patrick Cummins. They also have Shahbaz Nadeem, who has done exceptionally well for Daredevils. So yes, Delhi has always had a strong bowling attack. It's the batting that has been a constant failure the past two or three seasons. But now, since their batting seems to have come good, the bowlers need to deliver for Delhi once again.
Himanshu, a Delhi versus Punjab encounter generally had the ignominy of being the fight for the wooden spoon in tournaments. But this time, this is a match which seems to have a lot of expectations. Both teams this time seem to be quite determined to reach the playoffs here. What has changed for both these teams this time?
I don't see a much change happening, and Punjab seems to be a team on paper and on performance much ahead of Delhi. You know, somewhere except the one match, Delhi has actually not done much. I mean, we all know that they're a very heavy bowling side. In one of the matches, the batsmen did click. But we still don't see Delhi coming up to the expectation to get into the qualifyings. And, you know, the way they're playing, except one match, I haven't seen them as a unit coming in together.
Well,
so, you know, I would be very happy to see, as a Delhiite, to see Delhi wins today. But you know, a lot would depend on how much they contain the Punjab batsmen.
Yes.
And who wins the toss. Because toss is going to play a very major role in today's match.
Well, to be honest, Delhi Daredevils have only played two matches there, won one and have lost another. So it's a bit too premature to anoint them as title challengers or even ride them over the stage. But a lot of people call this the North Indian Derby. Do you feel there will be slight advantages? In fact, breaking news coming in at this point. Meanwhile, let's quickly dip into what's happening in match 13th. And it has been a big victory for Kolkata Knight Riders. They have notched a spirited show at the historical Eden Gardens here and have beaten championship holders Sunrisers Hyderabad after posting a challenging 172 runs. Kolkata's bowlers stood to task and helped the side defend the total. Earlier, Kolkata rode on a superb half century from Robin Uthappa to get to 172 for 6. Uthappa scored a 39 ball 68 and was well supported by Manish Pandey, who managed to get a handy 46 runs. They did fail to find momentum in the final three overs as Bhuvneshwar Kumar struck gold. But it was all for naught as KKR has defended the total. And with that, if I'm not mistaken, they have now moved to the top of the IPL standings here. And they've played four matches and have won three and lost one. And because of a superior net rate here, they're now above Mumbai here. So Rajkumar, despite what it looked like in the initial stages of the tournament, we are back to almost what's been a status quo in IPL for the past few seasons. Kolkata and Mumbai at the top of the league.
Yeah, Kolkata has been playing very well and Gautam is leading the team well. And most of their batsmen look in very good touch. Like Manish Pandey, if you see, he's been consistent. And Robin Uthappa, who is not getting runs now, he is also among the runs. So I think they are a very balanced side. You don't have very big names,
yes,
but they are utility cricketers. You know, all of them contributes and they play like a team. So that is a very dangerous team.
Indeed, and it's very easy, Himanshu, also to write a Sunrisers Hyderabad, but they are also a very competent team. Have you just witnessed what could possibly be one of the playoff matches for this tournament?
Well, you know, 2 days back we were discussing, and I did say that the last year the story of Sunrisers was repeated towards the end of the playoffs. And it is repeating right now. You know, after playing two very good matches in the beginning, they've suddenly come down. I don't know, there is something going wrong. Either they're depending too much on one or two players, because if you don't see Warner doing very well, there seems to be nothing happening in the team. They have very good lineup of bowlers. They have very good batsmen. I mean, Gale is not doing much. Shikhar Dhawan is not doing much. So they really need to put up, because see, basically it's a batting side. So they have a very, very good dominating batting. So if they don't click into batting, they're not getting back to the game at all. I mean, we saw it in last match, we saw it today. And it's very, very encouraging for the other teams to see that the top team which is coming into the tournament, a winner of the last year, losing two back-to-back matches, well, you know, some kind of a confidence is boosted on the team which is going to play next.
But again, these victories, at least this victory has come at the cost of a team which has been seen as one of the titans of IPL, Himanshu. Rajkumar has mentioned this already, that it's very important to find the right balance in IPL. Invariably, we've seen teams which are either too heavy on batting or too heavy when it comes to bowlers not being really consistent where it matters here. Now, KKR, if there's one team which is truly consistent for many years, it's KKR now. Does that make them almost impossible to defeat unless it's a freak game which goes wrong in, say, the playoff season?
No, I mean, we have seen chinks in Calcutta team also. I mean, then if you don't have two or three batsmen not clicking, you don't have Manish Pandey, you don't have Uthappan, you don't have Gautam Gambhir clicking, you almost have nothing happening in the team on the batting side. So they have a very good bowling side, but you know, but there are chinks and you can easily take on. If you take two or three wickets of these people I'm mentioning, then Kolkata can be easily overtaken by any other team. So any given day, if you have a very good bowling side coming in from there and cracks all or restrain these three players, Kolkata can be a side in trouble.
Indeed. Meanwhile, let's switch our focus back to that big encounter that is going to happen in a few minutes. And we understand that the toss has happened. Delhi Daredevils have won the toss and they are going to bat at this point here. So that's the big decision. Delhi Daredevils winning the toss and going to bat. Rajkumar, sir, do you think that's the right decision?
I think that is the right decision because this is the first game of the IPL in Delhi. Yes. And, you know, the wicket is new and nobody knows much about it. And as since I have played so much of cricket in Feroz Shah Kotla, the wicket gets slower and slower as the game yes. goes on. So it is always difficult later on, you know, to chase any target. Since it is a fresh wicket, you can go and get some
and
big
And we have
score.
Seen this trend in tosses here. Teams generally choose the strength in the second innings. So if you're like a team like Delhi, which has better bowlers and batsmen, will decide to bowl second so as to they know exactly what target to defend.
Yeah, that is also one of the issues. But here I would say it is because of the wicket, because wicket plays well, you know, initially in the first inning, and it gets slower and slower, and it makes it difficult to hit big shots later on. So that is why I think Delhi is considered to play first. You know.
And let's also not forget the due factor, Himanshu. Will that be a big decision? Was that a big reason for Zaheer Khan to decide to bat first?
Yes, I think yes, but you know, we have these all laid on new pitches and we've continuously seeing that the result we expect, that the past history we're seeing has been changing. And to me, it's not a very good toss. You know, the Jair should have thought of batting second instead of batting first. I mean, to me, it's not going to be a very, very exciting toss for them. So that's what I just now said, that the toss is going to be a very, very important factor. I mean, if you can't contain the Punjab team to 170-180, if Delhi is contained to say about 130 or 140, then Punjab is going to have a role today.
Absolutely, with the dew playing a very crucial factor in the second innings. Now, we have been discussing Zaheer Khan's decision to bat first, and let's go across to Sabha as well. Sabha, the big surprise for Delhi Daredevils, especially after last year, was the performance of Zaheer Khan as captain, something which we really didn't see him, at least that's the side which we didn't see when he was a cricketer, was playing for Team India. How much of an impact does Zaheer Khan have amongst the team when it comes to inspiring the youngsters?
I mean, it's remarkable, isn't it? Because Zaheer Khan, he doesn't play any cricket at all. There is no domestic cricket that Zaheer plays in the Ranji Trophy or the Dilip Trophy, even the one-day format. So he keeps himself fit only for the IPL. And the way he has led the side, the way he has marshaled his resources, all that is admirable. So I am very hopeful that Zaheer Khan once again can work on his experience that will help his youngsters to come good again.
Rajkumar, do you feel sometimes that perhaps Indian cricket missed out a trick on never really testing out the captaincy of Zaheer when he was playing for a team?
I think usually you don't make a fast bowler a captain because they have got, I mean, it is a difficult job bowling, fast bowling, and you know, after bowling a spell, a person is exhausted and is not thinking too much about the batsman or field placement, because usually if you see fast bowlers standing at the fine legs or third men, you know, so they are not very much involved. But as a cricketing brain, I would say Zaheer has got a very good cricketing brain because he has been helping all Indian bowlers. What I've seen, Dhoni had given him the charge to take care of all the bowlers. So he was very instrumental in helping them, guiding them where to bowl and how to bowl. So that way he was very intelligent. But since we had Dhoni, so there was no chance for anybody else because Dhoni has been a very successful and a very good captain for India.
Indeed. Himanshu, let's now discuss about Kings XI Punjab. What do you think should be their key strategy for this game? They have gone off to a good start. They've won three games and they've won two games out of the three that they've played. It's very their key strategy for this game. They've gone off to a good start. They've won three games and they've won two games out of the three that they've played. It's very important if they win this match, they will be in the playoff zone, at least among the top four of the eight IPL teams here. So what is the key thing they need to do really well?
I think today for them, as a crucial match today, is to see that they somehow contain. They have very good bowling lineup, mind you. Their bowlers aren't bad, you know, because these two, both Sharma boys, they bowl pretty well and they can come very handy at times. If we see them containing Delhi to a small total today, you know, they have a very good depth in batting. I mean, the batsmen one after the other, and they have till number seven, you have batsmen one after the other who could probably chase any kind of total. So I would say if they have this match with them within 150, 40, 50 for Delhi today, I think Kings Punjab 11 should do very well. So I think a lot would depend on how they shuffle their bowlers, how they move their bowlers on the top and the middle, because it's going to be a very, very intelligent captain's game today, because Zaheer on the other side, we know how intelligent he is when it comes to bowling. So it's going to be an intelligent Punjab captain today who restrains the Delhi team towards Zaheer Khan trying to stop them to chase the total.
Very interestingly put. Sabha, how important is it for Punjab to gain a foothold in this season?
I think the only way Kings XI Punjab can get back into this IPL, although they did get off to a good start, but somehow they need to work out a good composition. For instance, the last game they played one more seamer instead of getting another spinner in the side. So they have to work out the right kind of balance that will work for them in different conditions. So they need to be more flexible in working out their plans and working out the right kind of 11 to play on that specific day against a particular opposition on a given condition.
Well, thanks indeed, Sabha Karim, for your insight here. But now, before I head in for a short break, it's time for me to put my panelists in a spot and get their predictions. Rajkumar, I'm sure you must be conflicted here because I'm sure your heart bleeds for Delhi, but Punjab does seem to be the stronger side on paper.
Yeah, they look the better side. But the way Delhi has played the last game, I'm hopeful and I wish also that they do well and Delhi should win and Delhi will win.
So you're predicting a Delhi win?
Yes.
All right, we'll hold you to that at 11:30 today. And Himanshu, do you go the same way as well? You're a Delhiite as well. Does your heart bleed for the Daredevils?
Yes, but you know, at times your heart is on the left, but you know, you have to think rationally. So I think my money today is on Punjab.
All right, so one of you will be victorious when it comes to the predictions tonight at 11:30. But we are heading in for a short break. But on the other side, we look at the match which has just concluded between KKR and Sunrisers Hyderabad and discuss what went wrong for the losers and what went right for the winners. It's time for a short break. Stay with us. Alright, so Team Kolkata notched a spirited show at the historical Eden Gardens in match number 13 of the IPL after beating title holders Hyderabad. After posting a challenging 172, Kolkata's bowlers stood to task and helped restrict Sunrisers Hyderabad to 155. For KKR, the star batsmen were Robin Uthappa, who scored a 39-ball 68 and was well supported by Manish Pandey, who also got a handy 46 runs. This despite them finding to file any real momentum in the last three overs as well. But all's well that ends well for Kolkata Knight Riders. Rajkumar, Robin Uthappa is someone who has done really well, or he has tried really hard in all of the seasons of the IPL here in order to make his comeback into the domestic over scene. Now, obviously, with Mahendra Singh Dhoni still being the wicketkeeper in the limited ODI format here, its opportunities are limited. But do we see now a very interesting case being built up as to who could replace Dhoni in the limited overs format?
I think Dhoni would continue in one day at least. But in T20, as we have seen, Rishabh Pant has come. Earlier, Sanju Samson was a hot contender for that slot. And Robin Athappa has always been a very consistent player, but somehow...
Let's not forget Parthiv Patel and Ridhiman Sahab.
Both of them. Dinesh Karthik has done well.
Yes.
So there are a lot of choices, fortunately for the selectors, but unfortunately for those who are not getting selected.
Yes.
So I think it's a tough call for whosoever does well has got a good chance now, because Dhoni might carry on for some more time, but somebody has to replace him now.
In any match, we have seen this complete reinvention of Robin Athappa ever since he started keeping as well. Somehow he realized that his opening credentials was not the only thing that could take him to a permanent 11 spot. But this, again, version 2.0 of Robin Athappa quite seems to be quite impressive year after year.
Well, I don't see him coming back to the Indian side. I mean, that's for sure. We have very good youngsters, though. Yes. Sanju Samson, you have Ridhiman Shah, you have Karthik. I think there are better options, and I think he's gone by the past where you need a lot of consistency. He plays IPL pretty well, and he could be probably an asset for Kolkata team in terms of IPL. And I don't see much of him happening toward the Indian team, and I don't think the selectors are even looking at him. So that's my personal opinion. Well, I mean, if he makes a comeback, all the best to him. Because he has a soft corner. He's married to a tennis player, and I know her so well. So that could be a very good soft corner from my side. But I personally see no career for him coming back to the Indian side.
Rajkumar, KKR is captained by Gautam Gambhir, who has not been a part of the Indian team for a long time. But that certainly doesn't seem to have hampered his cricketing instinct, really, because he has been, as a captain, he's only been going from pillar to strength, from strength to strength. He's been the foundation of the champion KKR side as we know it today. And somehow he remains consistent and gets to know how to win matches for that year. Do you see that finally making a case for selectors?
Yeah, definitely. He's been a very consistent captain as well as a player. And if you see him in domestic cricket also, he's leading Delhi team, and he has been very competitive, very consistent with the bat also. So, I mean, he is sort of a guy who has not left hope that he can't make a comeback.
Yes.
And he stands a very good chance in this Champions Trophy, because I think with the amount of runs he's getting, I think he deserves a place in...
And with both Shikhar Dhawan and Rohit Sharma, not yet established.
Yes, unfortunately, Rohit has not been very consistent, and so is Shikhar. But I think Rohit would be there because he has done well. So there is a choice between Shikhar and Gautam. So whosoever does well stands.
Well, today at least, and as a terms on captaincy, today was the encounter between both these two openers. And as a captain, I believe Gautam has got the nod. But what is going wrong with Shikhar Dhawan? This was seen as a perfect format for him to make a comeback, but somehow run seems to be deserting him.
Yeah, I think he's playing too many shots too early. I mean, he's a very good player, and that is what he has shown playing for India. So I think with one or two big knocks, he would be back again. And because the phase comes to where any side reads back again. And any side reads you that you're good at this, you shouldn't be bowling there. So I think he has to improvise a bit and take his time on the wicket so to get bigger runs.
Himanshu, do you believe that we have seen the last of Shikhar Dhawan, and he has just not failed to, just failed to evolve with the times and become a better batsman with the years going by?
Well, last year, I had a lot of hope with Shikhar, but this year, the way he's going, I raise all my doubts on Shikhar. I don't see him coming back, especially two people in this team, is Gail and Shikhar. I'm not seeing much of them happening and being very, very dependent for their own teams. I'll be very happy if Shikhar can come back to any of these matches. But the way he's gone into the last three or four matches, I see very little hope of him bouncing back into the tournament.
Well, Hyderabad will be more than happy to have Shikhar Dhawan back in form. They do need it if they need to reach the playoffs. But for now, at least KKR can sit pretty after having achieved their immediate target of being the title, at least being the table toppers at this point. But let's not forget, we have a big match coming up now as well between Kings XI Punjab and Delhi Daredevils. Yeah, thank you so much, Rajkumar, and also Himanshu for joining us with your insights as usual. But now, before we head out to a short break, let's just take you through what's a very interesting video that has surfaced from the social media feed of Kings XI Punjab. The players of Kings XI doing what has become viral and famous as the mannequin challenge. We leave you with these interesting visuals here. Thanks for watching.
Had a good time.
It's a good delivery, full of length. That's gone for six runs.